when I was a little boy, at the age of 5, I had something in my pocket, keep a lot of folks alive. Now I'm
your parents and dealing about this whole thing again, like, how do you think you feel about it?
I got the butterflies really, but I don't know. The smaller ones, when I first cut myself, it was just a release. I had all this tension built up inside of me, and I was kind of I felt flat. I felt grey, like no emotions. It was kind of a way of proving to myself that I was still alive. I was probably about 16, I think, yeah, 16. This guy, one of my friends, he worked in a meat factory, a slaughterhouse, and at the factory they had their own knives and really sharp sort of big butcher knife things. And I took his knife, and I didn't take it with the intention of cutting myself. I took it with the intention of pissing him off, because I'm a vegetarian. And he was quite proud of the fact that he killed animals all day, every day, and got paid. I took it about a week later, and hit, like, just chopped into my arm. And I didn't realise quite how sharp it was. And it went straight through all the tendons in my hand and into the bone, and I was I had to be rushed to Barnstable Hospital, which is the nearest big hospital to where I come from, and then I had to be there for the evening, and then they bandaged it up, and then I had to get taken in the morning to Exeter Hospital to have plastic microsurgery to repair the tendons. And I was there for a few days. I had to wear a brace on my hand, like, to support my fingers for about a year afterwards. It's still not so good now. I can't make a gun shape like that with this hand. This one's a bit dodgy. And I still haven't really got much feeling there. So, it's a bit of a bad idea, really. But, there you go. I did them with just a kitchen knife. I was alone in my flat, like in a kind of weird old shop sort of thing. It was a shithole, but it was like, that was where I lived at the time. And I did them with a knife, and I lay in the bath, like, and I lost an incredible amount of blood, but it looked a lot anyway. It was all over the place. It was a real dirty mess. Because I'd been quite down before I did it, when I was with my friends, they were worried, and the police ended up coming over and breaking the door down, and they found me, and they called an ambulance, but I really didn't want to get in the ambulance, because I knew if I went to hospital I probably wouldn't have such bigger scars. But they would have patched me up, but they would have put me in the psychiatric ward, which I'd already been in, and I didn't think helped at all. I refused to get in the ambulance. And the ambulance men were telling me I was going to lose my arm, gangrene or whatever. I had to go to, and I just refused to go. And the next couple of weeks were quite scary because I had to keep changing my dressings and buying new ones from the chemist. And I'm no doctor, so I didn't. They looked really bad, but I just didn't want to go to hospital. So I patched myself up, and it worked.
So on the way back, what you got to remember
hey,
is,
you need a map, man.
Is Junction 18.
We got kind of lost on the way down, but we learnt from our mistakes.
Right.
Yeah.
So I think we'll be able to get back.
Okay. Very good.
Right. You just can't help yourself. Getting your map.
Look at it. It's lovely.
Mm.
He is good at it, though.
Well, yeah, I know. He knows it.
All right. That light up.
If you want to describe where you started getting tattoos on your arm?
But I started getting them because I'd get drunk with my friend. He's a really good friend called Mike, who does graffiti and stuff. And we just started playing around with needles and Indian ink. And eventually he made his own tattoo gun from a lady's electric leg shaver and proper tattoo needles, because he'd send off to distributors of tattoo goods and equipment and stuff and say that he owned his own tattoo shop, and they'd send him samples of everything. So he'd got this big build-up of tattoo stuff, inks and everything. And we started doing them, and then I realised when we were doing them that it was kind of like a pain sort of thing and sort of scarring yourself, but in a positive way. And I started really liking sort of tattooing him, and he'd tattoo me and stuff. And I can look back on it now, and I think that's probably part of the reason that I stopped cutting myself, because the tattooing was much more fun. And I like, when I look at the tattoos, rather than looking at the scars, reminds me of good times rather than bad. I mean, they're shit tattoos, but it's kind of like, it's a good thing that they're shit. Because I like shit things. When people say the music I listen to is shit, I know it's shit. That's why I like it.
The line I shoot will never miss. The way I make love to them, they can't resist. My main, I spell him A.